हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एमविंग्स एकेडमिक क्लासेस। आई एम अमित एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर न्यू टॉपिक अकॉर्डिंग टू द आरबीएससी सिलेबस। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यू टॉपिक मॉडल्स। सो बेसिकली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू नो व्हाट इज मॉडल। सो यू कैन से अ मॉडल इज अ ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब। यू कैन से a model is your auxiliary verb. So what is an auxiliary verb? A verb that is used to help the main verb to complete the sense of the sentence. So we can say the auxiliary verb is your helping verb. You can say the auxiliary verb is your helping verb. Now, these helping verbs can be divided into two parts. First is primary verbs, and second is modals. So about the primary verb, we have discussed in tense topic. So we can say the primary verbs are do, be and have. With do, we can form the following helping verbs, which are your primary: do, does and did. With the be verb, we can form is, am, are, was, were and been also. With the have, we can create have, has and had. So these are your primary verbs. Now let's talk about the modals. Modals. Followings are modals. These are can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must, ought to, same, used to, then need not, and last one is dare not, otherwise daren't. So followings are modals. Okay, so if following verb are given, then you can say the given verbs, otherwise given words, are modals. Out of these modals, 8 modals are spoken in the pairs. These are can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should. These are the modals which are generally spoken in pairs. The meaning of should and the meaning of must and the meaning of ought to. These three modals have the same meaning. Used to and would, these two modals have same meaning. Need not and dare not are used only in negative sense. Only negative sentence we can write need not or dare not. We cannot write need or dare in affirmative sentence. If they are written in affirmative sentence, in case they are men war, not a model. So these are model, and now learn some facts about the model. Some facts about the model. So what are the facts about the model? The first fact is models can be written in positive or negative sense. It means I can write can in affirmative sentence, in positive sentence. To make the negative sense, I can write cannot. As can is model, same cannot is also a model. You cannot say that cannot is not your model, it is also a model. Now second fact, a subject number doesn't have effect on model. It means models can be used with both numbers subject, both numbers subject. How I can write he can do, and I can also write they can do. So I interchange, otherwise I replace the subject. Here we have the subject. In the first example it is he, and in the second example it is they. In the first example he is singular subject, and in the second they is your plural subject. So a model can be used with both type of subject, whether it is singular or whether it is plural. Okay, so there is no effect of model on model of the number of subject. Now third fact is a model can be used to ask question. If you want to ask question, you can use a model. Okay, so how can we write a sentence in the form of question?
Can you help me? So in this question, we have, otherwise in this sentence, we have question mark at the end of the sentence. And in the beginning, we have modal. So when a question mark is given at the end of the sentence, that is your interrogative sentence. In the beginning, we can place a modal to ask the question. Next, main verb, first form is used with a modal. So with modal, we always use main verb first form. We cannot use main verb second, third or fourth form, otherwise fifth form with the modal. How? He can help me. In this sentence, we have can, and the given sentence is affirmative, because there is a no not or question mark in the sentence. So in the affirmative sentence, if modal is given, then we also use main verb first form. Here help is your main verb and it is first form. Second, he cannot help me. It is your negative sentence. Why it is negative? Because in this sentence we have cannot, and not represents to negative sentence. In this sentence we also have help. It is also a main verb first form. Here we have no effect of the type of sentence with the modal, whether it is affirmative or negative. In all types of sentence, we always use main verb first form with the modal. Let's have one more example. Can he help me? In this sentence, we have the question mark. If the question mark is given, then the given sentence is your interrogative. So whether sentence is interrogative, negative or affirmative, any type. With modal, we always use main verb first form. So remember, with modal, we always use main verb first form. It doesn't matter that what type sentence you have in the question. So these are three facts about the modal. Now, use of modal. Use of models. Models can be used in following conditions. In following condition, we can use a modal. So what are the condition? The conditions are, first, to show ability, otherwise capability, otherwise strength. Second, a model can be used for to take permission Third, to request Here we can use a model to take permission otherwise to give permission both conditions we have with the model okay next in possibility otherwise probability okay next is for past habits Next is for necessity Next is in compulsion Okay so these are the conditions in which we use models In following conditions, we can use models. Other than these conditions, we can also use model. So what are other conditions? To make promise. The next condition is to make promise to do promise we can also use a model okay so these are the conditions in which we can use models okay now we will see one by one all conditions in our next video thank you